Welcome, vinyl community and YouTubers everywhere. I'm going to do my Diana Krall album collection on vinyl. I'm going to do it in two parts, make it a little bit shorter, not quite such long videos. I have 14 albums, which is basically everything that she has on vinyl. A couple of them I have even an extra copy for a reason that you will find out when you watch the video. So I'm going to do this in two parts, make it a little bit shorter, and I'm going to start with the first 8 records that she did, starting with her first album in 1993. So most of the records I'll show fairly quick. A few of them I'll have a little more to say about, maybe a few comments. And a couple of the records, I'll have more information because there's aspects to it that I think is more interesting. So stay tuned for some Diana Krall. 14 records, like I say. Pretty good haul. Hard to pick up 14 records with a couple extra copies in there. Let's get started. Her first record, 1993, Stepping Out. I'll show you a little more of these. That was CD only back in those days, 1993. Now, in 2015, this was released in Europe, the one I just showed. Remastered, high-quality vinyl, gatefold. 180 gram, and I haven't even opened this up yet. Has a bonus track, has a download with it. Really happy to get this. These things that come out in the EU, usually after a year or so, we can get them from Elusive Disc or Acoustic Sounds or Music Matters or one of those. And I probably got this from Acoustic Sounds. But then I just happened to be messing around here last year over at Elusive Disc, and they had some stuff on sale, and they had this one on sale. Well, haven't opened this one yet either. Her original label was Just In Time. This was released in 2016, but this is a limited edition pressed in Canada on aubergine colored vinyl. Now, I don't know what that is, but on Discogs it says purple. So this is going to be on a beautiful purple vinyl. This is her first one. I will open these up here one of these days and listen to them. The aubergine, I'll probably just keep that sealed because I only need one download card and one record to listen to. So that's her first record, and we're off and running. Her second CD by title Only Trust Your Heart was CD only. I do not have that, at least as of a few days ago. It hasn't been repressed on vinyl yet. Just about all of her old records have been repressed on vinyl, many in just the last few years. And I think if you see one of these and you're interested, you should grab them. Here was her third album. Was CD only. It come out in 1996. This is ORG, Original Recordings Group, issued in 2016. I tried to do a little research on Original Recordings Group, and their website's been dormant for a couple years, and it's hard to find much out. But they seem to be putting out these records. This is remastered, mastered by Bernie Grundman, double LP, 180 gram, 45 RPM. And it's outstanding. Haven't opened this one yet either, okay? But this was the first CD of hers I bought when it come out, you know. And you want to get a start in the music business with all us old duffers, use an album cover like this, and you get more attention. And I even remember in the record stores, they had postcards that you could just pick up and take with this cover on it. They did a lot of promotion, and that's one of the things. She's a pretty good pianist and a pretty good singer, but the whole is greater than the sum of the parts. And part of the success has been she's often worked with Tony LaPuma, who died last year, as a producer. And the other thing, apparently she was interested in high quality sound at the beginning. That's what impressed me with the CDs. They were some of the best sounding CDs I had. And of course, these are some of the best sounding records that I've got. And this is a dedication to the Nat King Cole Trio. So I won't go read all the tunes. They're easy for you to check out. But double LP, really good tunes. If you have any interest in all, at all, this is one you should pick up. Number three. Our next album, called Love Scenes. Of course, these are all going to be CD only till we get up to my series two of these, where we're getting into the newer records. Was 1997, and ORG put it out on vinyl in 2010. Gorgeous packaging, Love Scenes. I didn't mention on the last one, these are on the Impulse label, so usually that's associated with high quality sound. Same thing here, 2 LP, 180 gram, 45 RPM, mastered by Bernie Grundman. I didn't mention on the last one that these are also pressed at RTI. Hey, I've opened this one up and listened to it. So, gorgeous record, and I felt fortunate that this record was still available in this kind of condition, because I don't know what the limits are on these. This one's actually numbered, and so the other one was numbered too. I didn't look at it. This is number 1174. So been 6 or 7 years since this record was issued, and I got 1174, so maybe these been moving kind of slow, but they're not going to be around forever, and just a fabulous record. Next in the line is this one. I'm going to have to get a real video camera, I guess, to get rid of this glare situation. Apologize for that. When I Look in Your Eyes, 1999. She'd only been going 6 years and was up to here. This is one of the ones I bought the CD when it came out. I love this record. This one's been opened and played. ORG issued it in 2009. I don't think that one's available anymore. The label, Verve, which is part of United Group now, put this out in 2016, and I believe this is the EU press. So, a little bit of fun thing in this one. Of course, around about this time, she got married to Elvis Costello, or maybe they were in a relationship. She has written very few songs, or at least recorded very few songs. One of the best tracks on this record is called Popsicle Toes. And you have to listen to the words, and the music's good. And for those of you out there with a foot fetish, maybe she's given a little bit away about Elvis. Anyway, just another fun aspect of the records. Musically, this is an outstanding record. Mastered by Al Smith. Doesn't say who cut the lacquer, but I believe this was an EU press, and so Could be anybody. Comes with, it's not a gatefold, but it comes with some extra pictures and information that tells about who the musicians are on each track. Won't take it out of the package there, but has the custom labels on them. All of these things are high quality. Again, I might have used the wrong name earlier, Tommy LaPuma. And again, he was the producer on this one. He didn't produce all of her records, but he was involved in the majority of them. And that's good news. So onward. Next one in line, and again, we're getting up to a little more of the modern time. They're still CD only when put out by the label, The Look of Love, 2001. In 2003, ORG issued this record on vinyl, but in 2015, it was a big enough seller, or they had sold out on the other one, and they had reissued it in my favorite kind of format. I'll read this and show you the album. Limited numbered edition, mastered by Bernie Grundman, pressed at RTI, 180 gram, 45 RPM. I got number 1814, 1814. Don't know how many of these they're going to make. Again, look at that cover. That has to help the record sales and even the CD sales. This way back in the days, I bought three of her CDs. This was the third one. Outstanding musically. One of my favorite tunes on here, lots of them, but the first one is wonderful. And first tune when you flip it over is Cry Me a River. One of the best ones. So again, this one probably still available, the high quality numbered edition. And I can't say this too many times. These are at the regular price, and they're not going to be around much longer. And if you want this quality, if you just want a CD or anything, it doesn't matter. But if you want this quality, I think these aren't going to be around. So when I was able to pick up these original recordings group, which is different from ORG Records, some other kind of name is similar, but outstanding record. Next up, live in Paris, 2002. She's cranking them out now. This was CD only, but just the next year, and the same year, ORG issued it. Sold so big in 2011, ORG issued it again, and in 2016, they issued one of those high-res versions. I don't have that. I have the one issued by the label here, which is an EU issue, and so again, this is real high quality sound. This was recorded at the Olympia Theater in Paris, a famous venue, by Al Smith. He was there to record it live. She's playing with the group she's played with a lot. Anthony Wilson guitar, John Clayton bass, Jeff Hamilton drums, produced by Tommy LaPuma and Al Smith. Those guys have worked together a lot. You got a great group. And a lot of you will probably prefer her live recordings. In my second group of her records, I'll have another live recording because it's a little more jazz. And maybe a little less, not radio friendly necessarily, but a little less poppy. She does a little more jazzy tunes. She let the musicians playing with her stretch out a little bit. So if you want to hear some good jazz and you're not the world's biggest fan, like me, of female vocals, this would be a record you would like. And this is 2016 copyright, so on the Verve label, I don't remember. I may have got this from Amazon, probably a very reasonable price. Pressed in the EU, real high quality, double LP, not gatefold. So it does come with the inner sleeve and a little more information about it and kind of a plain label there. So that's a good one, and those live records, I know some people like them, some people hate them, but in the case of our records, the live records are excellent, and of course you're recorded in a great old-time venue here with Al Smith on the board, so you can't go wrong. For those of you that are still with me, thank you for watching. I appreciate this. I know this is not to everyone's taste, but I've done very few of these where I do all of my collection. The next one that she did was CD only, and I don't have that one. And then the next, that was 2002. And then in 2004, this one, The Girl in the Other Room. And this was issued in 2016 on vinyl by the label, German pressing, German manufacturing. Diana Krall, The Girl in the Other Room. Another excellent record, pressed in Germany, produced by Tommy LaPuma, and recorded and mixed by Al Smith. Every one of her records are outstanding sound quality, no matter who did them. So you can't go wrong with them. I'm going to play this one when I get done with this video today, because this one's open. I've played it. I don't remember exactly what's on it. When you have so many of one artist, you get those few favorites and you play them and you forget about some of the others. And there's the record. Fairly plain labels, but again, all of these made in the EU, and can't believe that they'll be around forever, so I keep saying it. Grab them. One more record to go, and it's one of the ones I had the most fun with. The last Diana Krall record I'm going to show today has a little more interesting story, interesting to me, not this lap before this last Christmas, but before Christmas a year ago, I got this. On high-res download. I really liked it. Diana Krall, Christmas Songs, featuring the Clayton Hamilton Jazz Orchestra. Part of it a quartet, part of it with the orchestra. I'm going to have a clip at the end here just to give you a little taste of this. This was so good with the high-res download, I went ahead and ordered the CD. And I really love the cover. And one of the things about this record, it's jazz. Yes, it's Christmas music, but it's one of those records you can enjoy all year round. I was playing it just a little bit ago to refresh my memory on exactly what's going on a few of the tracks. It's just really enjoyable. The other thing about this is it was mastered at the Mastering Lab by Doug Sachs. Not so important with the CD. This item came out in 2005, basically CD only, with the exception that I'm going to show you here. And I got this, and I thought, boy, I'd like to have the record. So I went to Amazon. Yeah, you can get this on a record. Problem is, I love that cover. Well, they changed on the album. Doesn't have that cover. Well, I got the album, and look at this. I thought it said it didn't have the cover I want. See, there's the back. There's the cover I wanted on the back. Oh, there's the cover I wanted on the front. What's the deal? I wanted that cover on the record. I took the CD cover over to my print shop, had them do a high-res scan, had them print it out on good quality paper, and crop it to fit exactly. There's the cover that they have. Nothing wrong with that cover. This is not a gatefold, but I wanted this cover. I liked it so much, I didn't order the record initially because I was irritated about the cover. And then I decided, nope, I'll buy the cover and fix it myself. And record collectors were all crazy. It's a sickness. But later on, once I get into things more, I'm not going to take this one out. That record that I just got there was made in Germany in 2013. And so it's a really high quality record, really good sounding. And of course, they were originally mastered at the mastering lab. So the Sonics is fantastic. But look at this record. But the other thing on the back. This was issued in 2005 when the Christmas record came out by Classic Records, authorized from Verve. Why? I don't know. This is a gatefold. A special record, okay? This is 200 gram on Quiex SV-P vinyl, which is a super quiet vinyl. It's black. It's not clear. I haven't played this. I have opened it up and look at the gatefold, but you got to pay a little bit to get these Classic Records ones. They must have done a number of them, but they're not easy to come by. Matter of fact, I got the Quiet X vinyl, but they also did one in red vinyl, one in white vinyl, and one of the online dealers who actually has a physical facility not too far from where I live, he had the original sealed in red vinyl, $250. So if you guys are out digging and you have any interest in this record, and you see this cover on the record, it's probably one of those limited Classic Records albums, and pick it up. Fun thing to have, and I'm going to have a little sound clip so you can hear a little bit what this sounds like, but this is just one of the things in addition to the music that I enjoy about the record vinyl hobby. Got good news also for us vinyl collectors. I made a couple notes here. I thought it was interesting. The Classic Records on Quiet X vinyl on Discogs, it's graded 4.56 out of 5. People really enjoy that. Those are the people with the best taste. You know, I have that record. But the 2013 press, German press, got a 4.45, a tenth of a score lower on that press, and the CD only got 3.86. So we know about those CD guys. They don't have good taste. They graded it almost a whole point lower than the good vinyl guys do. So aren't we lucky?
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a one-horse open sleigh. Now the ground is white, go it while you're young. Take the girls tonight and sing this sleighing song. Just bet a bobtail bay, 240 as his speed. They and hitch him to an open sleigh and crack, you'll take the lead.
A little clip there just to give you a little taste of what the music is like. The sound quality on that clip is not anywhere near as good as what the actual record is. Also, the whole record doesn't include that giant brass section that you see there in the video. A few of the tunes have that. The Chico Hamilton Quartet is very laid back on some of the tracks, and some of the tracks you have just a little bit of sweetening with a little bit of brass in there, but not the heavy sound like you see on this first track on the CD, the album. And I think probably that video was shot for a TV special or something. It's interesting that the drummer's back in a soundproof room with headsets and everybody else is all in one big room. But wanted to give you a little taste, and stay tuned. Here shortly I will have number two, volume two of my Diana Krall, and not quite as many records in the next group. So stay tuned, and I hope you enjoyed this. See ya.